Well, as we just heard, there are plenty of issues important to the faithful on Election Day ballot, but is there such thing as a Catholic vote? Tonight, we take a closer look at that question and other trends as part of an exclusive survey from RealClear Opinion Research Polling and EWTN News. Joining me now are Carl Cannon, Washington Bureau Chief of RealClearPolitics, John Della Volpe, Director of Polling at RealClear Opinion Research, and Matthew Bunson, Executive Editor and Washington Bureau Chief for EWTN News. Welcome back to you all, gentlemen. John, as we discussed yesterday, this is the fourth poll conducted over the course of this year. What are the biggest trends that you've been tracking across the polls?
Well, thanks, Tracy. I think some things have changed. Some things haven't changed. So let's start with the trend that hasn't changed. When we conducted the first poll almost a year ago, it was released last November, Joe Biden led Donald Trump in a hypothetical matchup, 51-39 +12. In the fourth of our series of polls, the number is 52-40 in favor of Biden. So that 12-point advantage that Joe Biden started in this hypothetical general election matchup a year ago, he has held steady throughout the entire campaign until this point so far. What has changed, however, are the issues. The number of Catholic voters who are significantly concerned about the state of the economy is increased by 17 percentage points from 56-73% over the course of the last year. The number of Catholics concerned about the state of race relations in our country has increased by 11 percentage points during those two polls. So we've seen significant movement towards the importance of those two issues. In addition to that, healthcare and, of course, the coronavirus are on the top of that list as well. So those are some of the big factors. A year ago, we were talking immigration, national security, still important, but really kind of pale in comparison right now to healthcare, coronavirus, and the economy in the minds of likely Catholic voters.
Well, Carl, this is a question that gets asked all the time. Is there a Catholic vote? Your thoughts, is there a Catholic vote?
Well, you know, for the past year, in all these polls that John's done, four of them, Matthew and I have each written four articles about it, we have been interested in the differences within Catholicism. Hispanic Catholics, younger Catholics, Catholics who go to Mass daily versus Catholics who only go on Christmas or Easter. And those have been very interesting polls. But at this point in the campaign, we're in the stretch run now. Political writers like me say, okay, where are Catholics? And we don't differentiate. And so when our poll shows that Joe Biden is leading among Catholic, registered Catholic voters likely to vote by 12 points, that's a number that makes us sit up and take notice. Yes, it's been pretty steady, but we're in the home stretch now. And I don't think a candidate can spot 12 points among Roman Catholics and be elected. So what I'm focused on at this point, Tracy, is Donald Trump be able to close that gap or not? Because if he isn't, he's going to be like John Kerry. He's going to be like a candidate who didn't carry the Catholic vote and lost. John Kerry was Catholic. So is Joe Biden, but voters know Biden is Catholic, and they seem to gravitate towards him, Catholic voters. So that's what I'm thinking of now at this point.
Okay, thank you, Carl. Well, Matthew, this one's for you. This fourth poll looked again at the faith lives of Catholics. What did it find, and how does this impact how Catholics may vote?
One of the most important aspects of the polls that we've done for the last year is to delve into the faith lives of Catholics, and this fourth poll was no exception. And what we found is that just as we have seen throughout this last year, this major demarcation line, a gulf exists between Catholics who go to Mass on a daily or weekly basis and those who go to Mass much less frequently. When we see how this plays out, for example, in the belief in the real presence, 50% of all Catholics believe in the real presence. That number jumps to 70% among weekly attending Mass Catholics and drops to about almost 30% among those who don't. And when we look at confession, it's a similar thing. 40% of all Catholics go to confession at least monthly or yearly. But among weekly or more frequent Mass attending Catholics, that number again goes up to almost 70%. And astonishingly, Among those who go to mass only yearly or almost never, that number drops to 3%. How does that play out in terms of where Catholics look politically and are thinking politically? Well, if we consider that 43% of all Catholics in our poll believe that practicing Catholic politicians should follow church teaching on the issue of abortion, again, that number rises significantly among weekly attending mass Catholics and is half of that among those who go only rarely, if never. Those are the two groups that are the gulf right now, as I said. Those who attend Mass regularly are more likely to be voting for President Trump. Those who don't currently, as we found in this poll and others, are supporting Joe Biden. So that's something that we have to track as we head into those final weeks of the election.
Okay, thank you, Matthew. Quickly now, last question for each of you. And John, we're going to start with you. Will Catholics be the deciding vote in the presidential election?
I think they very well could be, Tracy. The overall national vote, a 12% lead, 12-point lead for Biden, is only 4% in the six battleground states. So Catholics could certainly play a key role, especially white independent Catholics. So that could be a sliver that Matthew talked about that could play a deciding role, especially in the Rust Belt states.
Carl, what about you? What do you think?
Well, Tracy, you know, when John F. Kennedy ran in 1960, he got about 80% of the Catholic vote, or higher. When John Kerry ran, John F. Kerry, who styled himself after Kennedy, he lost the Catholic vote to George W. Bush by 7 points in 2004. I think the Catholic vote is going to be decisive, and Joe Biden leading by double digits right now among Roman Catholics must make Democrats happy.
And Matthew, your thoughts?
Well, it goes back, as we have said from the beginning, to a lot of the battleground states. The polls we know among Catholics are much tighter there, probably within the 4 percentage points. The role, then, of Catholics who attend Mass more regularly, as it did in 2016, could prove decisive in certain key swing districts in places like Pennsylvania, Wisconsin, and even Michigan. So that's something, again, we'll have to keep an eye on.
Okay, we will leave it right there. Thank you so much. Matthew Bunson, Carl Cannon, and John Della Volpe. Thank you all.